Hello, let's discuss Gillespie's trial. Now, I haven't caught up. I haven't had a chance to read absolutely everything going on, so forgive me for this. But what I do know is they're trying to say, and could be right, could be wrong, but let's discuss. And this is the reason I want to discuss it. There are people on my social media who do not want to be named. There are people on my social media who use pseudonyms. There are people on my social media that if I said, could you come and stand next to me or come into this book or tell the story, they would be too scared to do so. Now, The Independent is trying to say that, oh, it also sounds so familiar that all these people that make accusations, because don't forget the royals are involved in this one. Now, these sorts of parties go on absolutely everywhere over the Christmas period. They go on in your cities, in your pubs, in your clubs, and every single city has a Freemasons Hall. They dance every night and they sing and they dance and they swill and they have their bills and their cool girls. This has been going on for generations and generations. It's not something that's been swept under the carpet. It's something that people have tolerated. Prostitution, drugs and alcohol and all of this shing diggity dings. It's been going on for years and years. But when somebody comes forward about a rape, assault, or trying to say that, look, hang on a minute, I was naive, I was young, I was foolish, I was stupid, and what these people were doing was wrong. But hang on a minute, there's a time frame. Hank's just not happened. You're safe. What do you mean you're talking about something that's happened? It's closed, it's locked down, things have gone on. They're not the same people now. Come on. Now, come on, get me. Hang on a minute. What's going on? Now, Gillespie and Prince Andrew. We don't know. We weren't there, but there's photographs of them. But who really cares? So what if Andrew wants a, and a, you know, and so what if these children are 13, 14, 15 at the time. What if, so what? But what if we have some photographs and happy times and maybe it was all right and even maybe had an orgasm sometimes? But is it right? Is it moral? Should we be talking about it or should they just be sweeping it back under the carpet, keeping you all distracted, keeping you all just fucked up, making sure that you're in complete confusion because you're getting all ready to be switched on? Now, in 5 years' time, they all want to have humanoids in every single one's house, but can you afford it? And what about all the medical things and how are we going to deal with this? Because it's coming, conspiracy theorists or not. I know this to be true because I learned from some of the best. They're classed as the people that are up there with the rest. They're called VIPs and special people, and they're all just multi-millionaires, billionaires, trillionaires. I've flown with the best, and I've been on yachts, and I've done shiggity digs, and I was an escort who got fucked by a judge as well. I did a threesome with an ex-psychologist who owned her own business. She went completely bankrupt. Her and her husband were already swingers. I tell this as a true story and I express it in my ways because of my shame and embarrassment in my old playgirl days. I wasn't a play bunny. I have never been. I couldn't imagine somebody sticking money in my tin. It's a bit embarrassing to think I could dance on a stage strafing off my clothes and looking a bit gazed. There's lots of men were looking at me as I was winding my legs, thinking I could dance in front of these people. God, no, close your legs. The thought of doing that is absolutely horrendous, but when you're just going into a hotel, it's not so horrendous. Behind closed doors you go. Some of them are train spotters, some of them are quite nice footballers, some of them judges, and some of them even preachers. Some of them quickly try to rub across a hundred couple of quid just so they can go for a quick dump and a dimp. I'm laughing, but it's all quite serious, what really is going on. But this is how I deal with this. Crack up, I will not. It will drive me to a nut ass where I will be sitting there rocking in a fucking corner like, I don't know, Sarah Connor maybe. So anyway, Terminator once warned us that these little things were going to come upon us. We conspiracy nutballs, they called us all, but where are you going to plug this thing in and how are they going to turn a robot and a human into a humanoid. And what's the difference, you ask? Just plug in, it's not a problem. Recharge, relax. Oh, the chair is so lovely. It's not a problem. iPhone ahead. We can all just sit back and relax with our heads as they put in our little chips and our little micro pins. And everybody said they were nothing but nut dins. But the time is coming in 5 years' time, they plan to make sure every single one of you and your DNA is all in their plan. Conspired, they did. The conspiracy nutballs, they did. They sat around their tables, the round table, once it was upon us, when King Arthur once said, "Behold, O Jesus, for you be gotten. If I talk in the spirit, this is going to turn into some mutton." So Gillespie, is it true? Is it not? What was she involved in it? But I can tell you a lot. I know of many people who hide in shame and embarrassment. They put on their caps and they connect to the system, but not in their real name. For my name really is Kelly, and it is who I am. And I'll even put the blue dot up there to say it. But then they get my passport and all my identification. They've already got that I'm nothing more than JR304480. See, I actually cracked my fucking neck then and it hurt. Ow, 2 seconds. Oh, wouldn't it be nice to be a chiropractor? I think I might train. Expensive it is to go and train. So anyway, this woman didn't have enough money. She had 4 kids and she was in a hurry. George Osborne announced he was going to make some benefit cuts, and oh my goodness, it was going to affect Miss C. Cotton right at the start. Although she decided that these people were not changing her destiny, for she had a roof over her head and her children, and it was lovely and everything else. And I'm going out of rhythm and rhyme because I'm going to go completely out of my fucking mind. Out my fucking mind I come. It's absolutely amazing because spending all your time trapped in your head will drive you crazy. Imagine talking to a judge all day, imagining what you're going to say and how you're going to feel as he fucking puts them in cuffs and takes them away. On Christmas Day, I believe this will be happening, for Christmas Day is a mighty day, for it is the true spirit upon us of the Northern Lights and the crossing. And there is astronomical things that would explain science and reason that Christianity just couldn't get their nut around, and neither could science, because they couldn't fathom the cell between mind and matter. For up they go, the linguistics and the professors, as they sit around, and the whiskey jackers. But hang on a minute, the Houses of Lords and Commons need to be snorting. For Father Christmas, he comes once again in his red and his Coca-Cola and his Coke in his bed, and the big trucks that once was a green little man, and then the trees and history began, and it got changed by commercialism, for I am gonna have a heart attack if I don't find my rhythm. Wouldn't it be nice? Would you do it, really? How many people are gonna take the ID chip? The new passport, and it will happen at customs and controls, and I'm not willing to cross that line alone with me and my kids. That's where it's going to happen. I'm staying in the UK to step up Britain. Pilot's license, boat sailing, I'm here in 2 water pace. So if anybody wants a Christmas present for me, I want to go sailing. No, I want my license. So I need my licenses for absolutely everything. Planes, mains, automobiles. I'd love my bike license. That'd be so fun. But I'm going to need a passenger for absolutely everything I do. And if you know me and you know me well, then you'll know that I grew up with sidecar racing, and you still get the thrill, and it's the most awesome thing to have somebody doing something that you can't do, but you still get to go along anyway, and in a sidecar is the most awesome thing. I thought me and Dean were going to become Thundercats, actually, and that is boat racing where there's 2 in a boat, and I really thought we would join a husband and wife team. So anyway, On that note, any husband and wife teams out there that want to really seriously get involved, I have noticed that somebody's come online, and I'm not going to get personal with that person at all because I have a letter that says that it is said person who does. Anyway, let's just... When good neighbours become good friends. Christmas party. Anyway, I live between five houses. Hopefully by the January, February, March, April, May, I aim to be out of here by the 31st of March. I'm all paid up until 31st of March, as you know. And I have a massive decision to make because obviously I'm strategic. I am a strategist, an interventionalist, coach, psychology degree, youth work degree. I specialize in attribution and trauma therapy. However, I'm also dealing with my own trauma at this particular point, which is really not nice because of said people that mean that they trigger and trauma the one thing that traumatizes me more than anything, and that is the removal of my children. And there is only one line of this world that can do that. No social worker can remove your child. No judge can remove your child. However, he can grant orders for your child to be removed, but he physically cannot turn up at your house and remove your child, nor has he ever. And sometimes a judge does like to get involved and come and see a family, but it takes one that doesn't give a shit about the money they're paid for and they give a shit about the real child. We don't have many of them, if any. No public person can take your child from you. That would be an absolute kidnap. No person, a father, can remove a child from a mother, and it's a civil matter to go to court on how that's going to work if they both can prove that they're on the birth certificate. Every single one of you, they can access it, and it doesn't take long for them to do it, and it's done through your child benefit. The person that holds the child benefit holds the key to the children, and that is what you're holding on to, really. And that is what your child is. Your child is their child benefit and their national insurance number when they become 16. And that is all they are to the state. Police are the only people that can remove your children from you. So hence why I have trauma. If any person brings the police to the front of my door, and that includes my children, that includes Dean, that includes my neighbours, that includes any one of you watching this, I choose to still be here after having a letter notifying, and I've done it live, that it is a member of my community and somebody who watches my live that is causing all of this problem since I went public dancing at the hospital when I showed you what was going on in the hospitals during this pandemic. We also sent a number of people in at different hospitals around the country, and a lot of people went to the hospitals to show you during the pandemic. I'm not saying people are not dying, because I said this is about depopulation, and this winter doesn't matter whether it's nature, nurture, science, reason, creation, man-made, or God or Mother Earth. We are all going to get oops upside the head. Every single fucking one of us this winter. Every single one of us is going to face the cold or a heat wave. Polarity exists. We are a bipolar world, and we live on an axis that spins, that creates obviously astronomy, which creates sun, moon, planet alignments, planetary, northern, south, east, west. How far do you want to go? I can talk to you about fucking anything because I'm just a fucking computer. No, I am not a humanoid. I actually am Kelly Cottom. I'm just fucking playing with your... So no, I'm not a humanoid. I could be. How many people do you reckon already have humanoids? I know of quite a lot of people that already have humanoids in their houses, working active in their houses. These people use retinas, these people use eyes. Have I been to these houses? Yes, I have, with many things that I've done with multi-level marketing, when you always get to go to the director's house and you get to listen to their sales pitch, and it's fucking awesome. You eat nice foods, you get to see lots of nice cars. Go and enjoy it. It's fun. I've done many. Don't forget also, Jacqueline, Ann Summers is run by women for women to enable them to feel confident about their sexuality. Actually, let me do this problem right for you. Ann Summers, hang on, let me do this really properly for you. Ann Summers is run by women for women to enable women to feel confident about their sexuality. Anyway, shall I also, I could go into a rap Maggie Thatcher if you wanted. Ruined the fucking world and said privatization was allowed. This is where it all went wrong. Maggie, you were wrong. I just got told to stop singing about that. Maggie, you were wrong. Look, water, gas, electric, all natural butanes, all gases, all things that we obtain through the earth, through the things that are used for the provision, for the best of our ability, so we can turn the lights on, have heat. Dean is currently in bed since probably goodness knows what time. Doesn't have a light in his proper bedroom. He's fucking huddled up, probably worried that his gas is going to run out. I'm laughing in some ways because I'm thinking, fucking touche, mate, because I was in a one-bedroom fucking flat with two babies. And as you know from my paperwork, it stated that I didn't hemorrhage straight away after Aaron. I hemorrhaged a bit after. Same happened with Elijah and Shiloh. Let me just put you here. Let me just put you on my pineapple for a minute. Let me just stick you back on my pineapple for a sec. Because I need to go and I need to get on and I need to make sure I'm ready for tomorrow. So let me just stick you on my pineapple right on a scorpion. So anyway, bring this back to what this is really about. Mothers are not high risk to their children, by the way. Most of these mothers go to their midwives and maternity people. And then they sit down and they talk about a birth plan. Within this birth plan, darling constructs a management plan to make sure the mother pops the child's head out of her vagina and onto her breast immediately and rocks and nurtures her child. Now, one said issue comes because we have a multi-agency framework, darling, and in comes the child protection when mother becomes a high risk, because they've got to make sure that if mother said dies, that we know what's doing with the baby, darling. Is the father going to take it? The grandparents? Fuck knows. Well, somebody like me, sweetheart, was a high-risk pregnancy. I was chance of hemorrhaging and basically dying. So luckily we have this thing called medical intervention, and it means they can stick a little injection in my bum. It means it stops me from clotting, stops me from bump, and it contracts my womb and goes bump. But we don't talk about maternity anymore, do we, love? Because men don't want to talk about periods, and people can't handle a fucking woman who's about to come on. And why the fuck can't we just sit in bed and eat ice cream? Wouldn't that really not be dumb? Better not have women on a period at work. Now, don't forget, sir, what is it said? You can't even sit on a sofa after a woman who has just bled. Just bled, she has come, he said. It's got blood on it. Do we have sex now? But these little things we just don't talk about because it's so fucking personal. But it creates a baby. Children, they said, both of them have slept in my bed. Breastfed they were, we slept nights cuddling, and the midwife says, no, you can't do this, darling. Every single one of my children has slept in my bed. I co-sleep with them all, but they want to label this shit. Alternative mother, they said, no, you're wrong. Even in the hospital, my children were in my arm. You can't do this in a hospital bed, so home, I said, I will go where I can rest and lay with my children instead of the fluorescent lights and the and waking you up to ask if you'd like a sleeping pill. Hospitals, I hate, I really don't. I'm on a mission to create something very different for people like us in EDS world, to make sure that mothers actually can have babies and children. But hang on a minute, there's a 50-50 chance. Now, if you had AIDS, wouldn't you have a 50-50 chance? Or Down syndrome, would you? pass it on to your child. DNA, they say. Hang on a minute, we can interrupt. We can get in there and we can change. DNA, they said. So how are they going to change that? What do you think they're going to do? Who's working on this? Now, you're not, because you're too busy watching EastEnders or laying in bed or getting fucked up the arse or taking it the other way. But some of them are sitting there, scientists, working on this every day. They're trying to get rid of cancers. They're trying to do this. But hang on a minute. We've already got this. Where is my cup? She says it's sitting on the floor because that's where I spend most of my time. Be kind, neighbours. You never know what battle somebody's facing and you might just be the one triggering them off. A lemon, she said, in her water. And ginger too, actually. Ran out of honey because the honey is what? 16 pounds. But don't forget about the bees. It all comes back to nature and nurture, darling. But some of us have got a disease. A disease, they say. Dis-ease of the mind. Dis-ease and out of balance. Because we just can't be kind. Be kind we can. Why can you not do this? It's so easy to help but not hinder. And if you choose to hinder, fuck off you may be, because this summer and this winter, I'm coming bigger, better, harder and faster, and it's going to bring more people. I wonder what that spells, I don't know, who knows. But be kind, seriously. If you can have one gift this Christmas that you bless yourself with, and that's just to be kind. I remember, just before I go, when Elijah was a baby and he used to sit there with him and he used to sit there in his arms and he used to bless him with what he wanted him to have and be, his characteristics. And he used to sit there and the first thing he said was kind, you're beautiful, you've got a lovely heart, all this sort of stuff. But the first thing it was is you're a kind, lovely little boy. You know, you're going to be a kind man. And to be kind, it's not easy for a lot of people to do because everybody's in a rush, and in this particular season, it's very difficult to be kind to somebody. Now, we've got somebody in our community at the moment that everybody needs to be really kind to. It's up to her who she shares her battles with. But again, it's something that there's already a cure for. And I have to sit back and watch somebody else go through this system again. And I'm going to lose another friend. And it's sad. And she has been a friend. Ding! Doesn't necessarily agree. However, she has been a friend. It's been beautiful to take my boys out feeding the foxes. It's been beautiful to even interact and be part of watching a maned, matted little cub become a fox that watches me skate down the hill and will race me from the top to the bottom. And, you know, we haven't actually gone near each other like I did with the seal. But the seal was different when he was with... I carried the seal in that case in the end because she really struggled. And... but he couldn't bite me, and I did say, can he bite through the thing? She said no. I bet you there has been a seal to bite through it, and I wouldn't want to be the one that had the seal bite and a fox bite. But if I was bit by a dog or an animal, would I have a tetanus? Yes, of course I would have a tetanus. I trust them on things like this because you can get really bad diseases. I have never, ever, 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 ever said that illness doesn't necessarily need medical intervention. What I've said is don't be a guinea pig to something that I can 100% tell you was planned. I promise you by the hand on my heart, by Aaron Faith, Liam Daniel, Aaron or Faith, a fucking pinky promise that all this information and all this stuff that I've shared with you over the last 11 years, and if anyone could actually really put the last 11 years and before, and I am doing it in my book court case, for me to justify myself more than anything, so I can go to my kids and say, look, you know, I wasn't a bad mum. Just sometimes broke, sometimes I had money, sometimes I could give you the trainers that you wanted, sometimes I couldn't, sometimes your dad helped me out, sometimes I could pay for snowboarding, sometimes I couldn't. It was about getting that financial stability for me. It always has been. So for me, and the best thing I ever learnt from all of them people, and hats off to them, Tony Robbins, Richard Branson, Alan Sugar, Donald Trump, whatever, bless his heart, yes. Yes, bless all their hearts, like seriously, even if they think with their dicks, like bless their hearts. Tony Robbins have been married. I don't know what goes on inside their things, but they're very happily married. Guess been divorced. I've been divorced. Many people have been divorced. Many of us have got broken hearts. But I think one thing that's really beautiful, and too many people, and it's wonderful, will look at Christmas movies and go like, yes, we're going to go ice skating. Yes, we're going to do these things. And I do it. I love it. I love Christmas movies. But I think I just would like for people not to get depressed in expectations that are not going to happen. And lockdown, you know it's coming. You know they're going to do it to you. You know this. You know that they're going to implement so much on you. So find your own happy space. Find your own little place. Go there. And really just think. So please join us the 11th to... Well, join me... What day am I on? Shit, what day am I on? Monday. Okay, so join me Thursday for Alan at Portsmouth History Museum, and it's for Alan, who lives on the streets here in Portsmouth. There's a bit of a battle on whether I can take the kids, so I could do with Dean getting his ass over here, but I think he's struggling, and I don't think we want to meet until Christmas. I don't really know if I want to spend Christmas with him. I've got the kids, I've got the boys, I've got the amateur. I want to kill him for just me being a womb, because I'm more than a fucking womb. I'm more than a storage keeper. I'm more than a fuck. That's what I say to him. When I told him to go. Okay, you've got two choices, mate. You can get your own little stuff that I actually sort out and sort for you, and you can put it away. Because there was a time I used to buy in socks and put things away for Dean, yeah? And then one day I pulled it all out and put it in the bottom of the cupboard, yeah? Because he gets his backpack and he goes, obviously I get it. I get the graffiti, I get the fucking music, I get the art, I get it, yeah? And I get he's doing it on a whim. I get it. I support him as an artist. I don't agree with him. And I've always said, for the people that he is, because of my son, mate, I said, don't think I ever respect any of what he does. I never have done. I don't agree with what he gets involved in. I don't like what he does. I don't always like the art, as you fucking know. I'm very personal about the fact that I don't like the fucking art. I've told him to stop doing all this miserable fucking bollocks and start getting all fucking happy. And nobody is giving their fucking hearts away, and everyone is taking their hearts back. And, you know, put your hands, hearts here, like here, like don't throw your hearts away, put your fucking hands here, like really, do you know what I mean? So thanks for the reminder from Oliver, who, don't forget people, Oliver also faced a massive injustice, was imprisoned for a crime that he didn't commit, and still seeks his own peace of mind and acceptance in what they've put him through, and deserves to rightfully have his paperwork corrected and to be free as a free man, to walk as an innocent man, because he was innocent, just like my Uncle Sam was. And okay, we don't always do things the right way. We trial and error. Yes, there's the Bible. Yes, there's things around to guide us. Yes, some of us have parents that guide you like gooses, and they'll take you snowboarding for the winter, and they'll take you sailing for the summer, and you'll live in the seasons as parents are meant to do, not being institutionalized, because this system that's up here was created for the dumbasses that can't teach their own children. It wasn't created from those, yes. Yes, they use private schools, some of them even boarding schools, but don't forget, their children are not here, yeah? So I will say, this is the one space where I will agree with Stephen Morgan, the MP here, about children in schools knowing who they are, which is what he's pushing, and finding out who they are. But it doesn't tailor for people like us, who have got the dentist tomorrow, medical matters to deal with, managing a condition with people that don't get it, and just basically getting on with our lives, knowing that we can live to the best of our ability, and when there's an emergency, it's okay, and having that financial freedom, because financial freedom is something, yes, financial freedom, but financial freedom is something completely different. You've got spenders, and I'll leave you with this, you've got spenders who literally get their money and spend, you've got the savers that get their money and save it, and then you've got the investors. And the investors are the people that are leading the world. They're the pioneers. They're the people that have taken over the 60,000 government that was set. They're the people that are leading the way. They're the people that are triumphing a lot of this stuff. But some of it, it needs to be up for discussion with everybody, because we are all equal beings. We are all entitled. They don't like this word. We are all gifted and blessed with our own tools, our own skills, our own passions to be who we are, created in the way that we are. And yes, running in the sea is the most awesome, wonderful thing to reset your body every day. We were given the sea. We were blessed with the sea. So if you have the sea around you, get up in the mornings, jump into the sea. Even if you're scared of what's in it, this is why we've got lifeguards. This is why we've got oceanary people, and they'll create safe places if there really was something in the water. So this is why it's really important that if you do leave sea life, do leave them, because their mothers and fathers are really fucking mental, mate, and they'll have you, or they'll abandon the child. So keeping families together, even all of the seals and the lions and the tigers and the dogs and the cats and the rats and the us, you know, keep humanoids want babies too, apparently. So we are going to have to integrate to a certain level with technology for the sake of people like me who have cranial instability, which means that I need an upright MRI scan, chiropractor, and all of this stuff that men, humans, can't see. And it takes for certain level of technology to come through that could make a real difference for people with spinal, brain, heart, lungs. Yes, there's a lot of other stuff, but this is where I think it should be stopped, halted this Christmas. Like, do not continue with this over this Christmas with what they're going to do, and actually discuss about it and educate people about how this is actually helping people with spinal injuries, Parkinson's disease, and really helping people who are immobile in wheelchairs come alive. And if it wasn't for the technology with Stephen Hawking, they would have never have ever had that man's mind. Whether it's right or wrong or whatever, his mind was one of the most brilliant, awesome minds, but it was trapped in a condition that was eventually taking him, as any condition will take us. Mine is a degenerative condition as well. I'm past my sell-by date already. I live every day. I want to get on, and I really do. But I want to take you guys with us. I don't want to leave any of you behind to get caught up in something that in 5, 10 years, you're going to go, why did we not listen to them people? Why did we go with it? Why did we not stand up for ourselves? Why did we not stand up for our families? Why did we not protect our own families? And whatever shit issues you've got with people in your families, even if you've got someone on the streets, even fucking Josie, mate, if any of her family, fucking get her off the street. She's not my responsibility. I've done as much as I can. I believe she's pregnant. So her family have got to step in there now. Hers have got to heal. Hers have got to get on with their shit. And I just pray for you all. I just pray that whatever was been gone is gone. And as we come along into this Christmas, that the Holy Spirit fall upon you all, that you understand the true gift of Christmas. And it's not commercialism, and it's not all the toys, and you're not to go out and buy. And that meal on your table that you have on for Christmas is a meal that you're entitled to eat every day, if that's what you want to. Or vegetarian, go your way. Either way. We are going to be eating animals because there is a cycle, but should we eat humans? So let's discuss. It's all right to talk about this stuff, but we're the ones that have got to grab them by the ears and say, right, House of Commons, House of Lords, you meet all together now, because we are not common people, and we are not upper class, and we are not middle class. It's all defined about whether we're an investor, whether we're a spender, or whether we're a saver. So don't get manipulated. Spend, save, and invest.